And welcome back, it's Helen Godden here, and here we are together for the last time for block number 9 of our Flower Power 2 Quilt Along. Yes, it's been a lot of fun, and I hope you've stuck it out to the end with me here. I've been seeing some amazing samples online, and I really appreciate everyone that's joined in, had fun, had a positive attitude, and just given this a go. That's what it's all about, folks. And we're loving seeing all the variations. It's really quite exciting to see how everyone interprets these designs. I love variety. I love seeing people take my designs one step further and make it their own, okay? That's been awesome. You know the routine. I've traced it, I've put it onto my batting, I've ditch stitched it, I've got my black thread, and I've got my snazzy scissors. These are the rose gold ones, and I'm going to do my straight background parallel line stitching. And maybe by now you've guessed what I'm doing with that, is that with each block it's going to have like the flying geese all going one way in one row, and then the other way in the next row, and you're going to have that consistency of the horizontal stripe going through it to sort of bring it all together. I can see a little bit in there. You wouldn't think it makes a difference, but it does, okay? Because what it does is link those areas to each other, which pushes them all back and lets the flower be on top, okay? Because otherwise those negative spaces are pretty small, but that makes them link together as being the background. You can see I've just stitched over the twiddly bits, as they're technically called, and I think it looks fun. I don't think you sort of notice that at all, that it's stitched over. Okay, the leaves on this one. You can see there how giving that just the slightest of curve changes that leaf so much than if we had just given it straight lines, it would just be flat. Okay, now that leaf feels like it has movement. I'm liking that. Okay, I'm going to show you a design down here. A design I call squared off, where I basically make a square and then over make it. So I'm stitching a square, so every line I'm going to stitch is going to be horizontal and vertical, and hopefully getting fairly regular, you know, right angles. But when I make that square, I'm going to keep stitching past it and over complete the square to then start making another squarish shape. Now I say square, I mean squares and rectangles, things with 90 degree corners, so that everything is in that horizontal or vertical format. I start to get childhood flashbacks to the 70s of curtain designs at my auntie's house. Oh dear. There we go, and that's pretty evenly covered. I'm liking that. Up the top here, let's go with something a bit more organic and wavy, etc. In keeping with that, but not compete with that. I did mention wallpaper before, didn't I? Let's go with some more wallpaper. Thank you. So one of the advantages of this kind of design is this wallpaper idea, where I make up sets of the old style Regency stripes. But see how this area is left blank? Well, it gives more interest to the pattern, but it also means I have to stitch less. Okay, so less is actually more, which is so not my theory, but in this case it is. So the negative space that I leave behind is just as much the pattern as the pattern. And you can see there again how important it is to just do half of the pattern so that it implies the rest of it goes behind. You know what? I don't think I'm going to quilt any more on the passion flower other than more of the stamens, because there's not much space in those petals. So I'm just going to come back in here and just do the stamens. Now this is very technical, okay? Pay attention. When I stitch out on the stamen, I get to the little dot and just do a little squiggle. Like a little nervous twitch, okay? You can see it's a teeny weeny movement, just enough for the stitches to just make a little kind of a blob. There we go, I'm pretty happy with that. Little nervous twitch stitching, but it has brought forward those stamens and made them a bit more of a feature. You might decide to do some scribbly fill in here. Which also just adds more black, because sometimes the Sharpie looks grey rather than black. So there we go. Let's cut that one away from the thread. That is the passion flower. That is block 9 of our Flower Power Quilt Along number 2 with Helen Godden. I've had a lot of fun and I hope you have too. So now the question is, how would I finish these off? Now what I will do with my blocks is trim them back to say 12 inches or whatever size that works out to be, so that I've trimmed back nice and neatly with the batting, so it's nice and trimmed, and then I'll be able to butt them up to each other quite neatly, okay, and make sure everything's lined up, and then I'll do a fairly wide zigzag on the domestic machine, okay, with my zigzag set to a wide setting, and butt joint those battings etc. together, and then I'm going to make a faux sashing. So I might cut a 2-inch sashing, fold the 1/4-inch under on either side to make it like a big piece of bias, if you like, and then literally use a strip of iron-on webbing like Wonder Under or Vliza Fix and literally iron that on top, and then some satin stitch or blanket stitch down either side of that sashing. So in that way I take it from being blocks to being a whole quilt top with faux sashings. Now there's many different ways you could decide to finish these. Some of you are using them as placemats, some of you are turning them into bags or cushions. There's endless variety of what you could do with them. But I'm so glad you joined us, and I hope you've enjoyed all 9 blocks of our lovely Flower Power. And thank you very much. Thank you for being here. Thanks for having fun. Thanks for learning together. It's been wonderful, and I'm looking forward to seeing all your variations and sort of rejoicing in everyone's different approaches. See you later, everyone. This is Helen Godden for Education and Inspiration, and that's the end of our Flower Power 2 Quilt Along. See you later. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye. Bye.